Welcome, fellow patriots.
Yeah!
That was horrible. Love, find common ground to hold the spread of lies. And any. America first! America today we are going to take the white privilege test, react to some gay blues clues, and more other gay clips, and we are going to be diving into gay Disney things Disney's added.
Basically just the leftist thing.
Yeah, just the average thing. Alright, so I guess I'll read even... don't read it. It's got to be a surprise.
Alright.
I'll read even numbers, and you read odd numbers.
I read the odds.
Here. Suit up. Alright.
This is going
to
be...
So this white privilege test, we answer yes or no to these questions, and the more questions we answer yes to, I guess the more racist we are.
White supremacy, I guess.
Exactly. Alright. You ready? Start off at the first numbers.
Alrighty. If I wish to, I can arrange to be in the company of people of my race most of the time.
Who gets that butt hurt about the company they join? They're like, there's not enough Chinese in here.
Bro, I don't know.
I'm not joining a job and looking for white people and being like, I'm not going to join that job if there's too many blacks in there.
There needs to be at least one of every single race on the planet Earth.
I guess yes. That is a why.
That is a fat why.
I can be sure no matter where I move to, my neighbors in that location will be pleasant and neutral to me.
Alright, okay.
Alright, let's talk about that one.
Wait, it doesn't specify where.
No, like, it doesn't specify where, and what does neutral mean? Like, are the neighbors going to be like, oh my gosh, the new neighbor's black. Let's egg him.
I don't understand. Like, it could be in the best place ever. And
it kind of depends where you move. If you move into a crappy neighborhood, your neighbor's going to hate you no matter what.
Yeah. And it doesn't say anything about
like the Karen,
race or anything.
Like the Karen movie.
Yes.
The new neighbors are black.
Gotta install some cameras.
Install some security cameras, guys. I think there's a hardware store for that.
Yeah.
There's the black neighbor section.
I think that's a yes.
Right. Yeah.
Actually...
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'll just do yes. My neighbors aren't bad. Just kidding. I hate your neighbors. Alright.
I can go shopping alone and be sure that I won't be followed or harassed.
We got a black person in aisle 5. We got a black person in aisle 5.
Clean up on aisle five.
All units, please clean up on aisle 5. You just see everyone like following them around like the Secret Service.
Dude, I could just see a whole band of white people just putting on glasses and staring at
me. Alright, at what point, though, do you join a job and they're like, okay, watch the black people? Like, no boss is telling you that.
And another thing is...
Who's that self-conscious, too? Like, they go into a store and then they're just getting followed around.
And another thing is, I'm sorry to the feminist community, but my masculinity going... to into stores, I am fine.
Yeah. Just kidding, I'm not. I get harassed all the time. They fault me. I mean, maybe it's because I'm dressed as Spider-Man, but I don't know.
Maybe it's because I snagged a few things.
Maybe it's because I'm grabbing stuff, but it's probably because I'm white. I can turn on the television, open a newspaper, and see people of my race widely represent. Who righted this crap? You know, honestly, the backstory to this is that at a college class, the professor would give them extra credit for taking this test.
Actually?
Yeah. I guess we're doing it for free. I should have just waited till college.
Wait, did he grade us? Did he grade them on it?
Yeah, no, he gave them extra credit, though.
If they just did it?
Mm-hmm.
Bro.
Alright.
I could turn on the television.
Yeah, I already read that.
Open a newspaper and see.
Alright, the thing about that is, depends on what you're opening. If you're opening, like, a, I don't know, like a movie with white people or... It really depends on the time and what you're reading. Like,
it honestly doesn't really matter.
I don't know. I see black people on movies.
Hold up.
I see Chinese people on movies all the time.
Hold up.
What?
Newspaper.
Yeah, who knew?
Newspaper is black and white. Oh, you can't see their race.
Mm-hmm.
Loophole.
Yeah, shut up. Shut up, idiot.
So that is a no or yes?
I'm writing yes.
Yes.
First of all, who even reads a newspaper?
I don't know.
Get the paper.
The second we get a newspaper at our house, we just throw it straight away.
Yeah, who uses a newspaper?
All right, should I go on to number
five?
Yeah. I can go to a museum or art gallery and will see people of my race widely represented in the objects and artwork.
Can I just put out one point that what kind of shizbag goes to a museum still and takes it serious, like, this is an extravagant Walt person picture? Like, it goes, alright, I'm writing no because I don't even go to museums. I can be sure that when told about our national heritage or about civilization, I am shown that people of my color made it what it is. Okay, I think there were so many popular people in history that I can name are white, like Frederick Douglass and Martin Luther King.
Yeah, like they're great examples. What's her name? Rosa Parks?
Harriet Tubman.
Like, that's just a few.
Yeah, I'm white and I'm naming this crap. So shut up.
I guarantee you people in the comments that are watching this video won't know half of those people that we just named.
No. I can be sure. Oh wait, that's this is yours. I got excited.
This
white privilege. Yeah.
I can be sure that my children will be taught a curriculum which testifies the existence of their race.
What school? Wait. The teachers are going to school. They're in the college, and they're like, okay, let's make sure black people never happened.
They just wipe them off the face of the planet.
Just Thanos snap them out of reality because they never happened. Alright, I can go into a shop and easily find food, music, clothes which represent race or fit my cultural...
What?
Wait, why is food even on that list? I like black people flavored food.
Does that mean, burnt or what? I'm just confused on what that means.
Panda Express is a little Chinese. I feel left out at Panda Express.
Hey, that's the most Americanized food ever.
That's probably true.
Our backdrop is falling. It's falling.
Just leave it. So it was the stupid test.
It's the stupid test that's making your patriotism fall.
Just gives up. Yeah, that's representation right there. Yeah, hope you enjoyed that.
All right, number 9.
Yes.
I can go to a hairdresser and be sure that they can cut my hair.
Just a black person walks in. Can you cut my hair white person style?
Mm-hmm. Black people are supposed to have hair.
Wakanda forever.
Oh, shoot.
And I just got canceled. And I just got canceled. Oh, frick.
Oh, shoot.
I'm gonna say yes.
Good thing we're not gonna get monetized because if
no, we're just starting.
Gotten demonetized right there.
YouTube, this one's for you. I can't believe I just said that.
Oh no, just keeps going.
Okay, I can count on my skin color not to work against the appearance on my financial reliability. I'm just gonna skip this one and write yes. Let's just not even dive into that one for being so stupid.
And I'm 16, so who cares? Alright, there's this one. 11.
Yes, sir.
Here we go. Oh, I can swear, dress scruffly, or not answer letters without having people attribute these choices to the bad world. Poverty or illiteracy of my race. Okay.
First of all, this one's just justifying being an a-hole. Someone's like swearing, and someone's like, don't swear. What's because I'm black? You wouldn't get mad at me if I was white.
It's part of my culture.
My culture involves a lot of swearing.
They say prayers every night, and each one includes at least 5 swear words.
You freaking cracker.
I'm gonna
write no because I don't even swear or dress scruffly. Actually, yes I do. I'm wearing a thong underneath this. Idiots. Or not answer letters. How about just send a text?
Someone texts you. Sorry, I can't answer.
Yeah, I'm saying no. Yeah. I can't answer.
According to my culture and race, I cannot answer this text at the moment.
Just a week later, you get a letter that says, I didn't answer you because I was black!
You stupid idiot.
Suck on that! I can speak in public to a powerful male group without putting my race on trial. What is this, a court case?
You just start talking to this big group of men. They're like, no!
No,
you cannot
do
that.
Shut up, you Chinese idiot. I hate Chinese.
Wing chong ching chong, enough!
Back to China, you piece of
yes?
Yeah, I'm saying yes, except when do I speak to a powerful group?
Hey, I did go to a court meeting one time when I was 14 years old.
Same here.
So, we're good.
Alright, but I can't even name a powerful male group that I know.
Definitely, I gotta go with the followers of James Charles. That is a powerful...
Actually, they are male. They can determine their gender.
They slash them.
Yeah, Zay-zem.
Zay-zem, they slash them.
Whatever the frick there is.
13?
Yeah.
I can do well professionally without being called a credit to my race.
You did good, but it's because you're white.
It's just, your brain is hardwired to be white, so that's how you
got it. I'm just so freaking white, I'm sorry.
I'm gonna put yes.
Yeah, that's a yes. I am never asked to speak for my entire racial group.
What? I am never...
Why do I feel guilty for answering yes on this one, though? I'm like... But actually, I've never been asked.
To speak for your whole racial group?
No, when have you been asked to speak for a racial group?
It's like, they're all standing in a circle having a debate about which race is better, and then you get thrown into the middle.
Okay, though, could you imagine, though, like, at, like, a... I don't know, like, a debate or some like presidential thing at the Supreme Court, and they're all like, okay, I am a representative of black people. Like, no one's representing a race in those. Like, just point that out. That's never happened. Imagine the backlash.
It's not like a thing. Like, the second you say that, people are like obviously gonna assume you're towards one side or the other of that race.
I'm only here because I'm white. If I was black, I wouldn't even be here. I'd probably be under the knee of some cop.
Oh, shoot.
Canceled again.
Again. Kapow. I'm gonna put...
Oh, yeah.
I've never... So, I'm gonna put yes, because I've never...
Yeah, I'm gonna put no, because I've never asked. Oh, wait, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, wait.
Wait.
Hold up. Okay, I can remain oblivious of the language and customs of persons of color without feeling, in my own culture, any penalty for such oblivion. Oblivious? Okay, so, okay.
I'm
not gonna
get
this right.
Yes, because I didn't even pay attention to that.
Yeah. Okay. This one is worded weird. Okay, let me get this right. Oblivious of the language. So is that saying, like, you don't care? Like, yeah. Basically, someone says something that, like, is different than your culture, and you just, like... Like, it just flies by you.
Oh, right.
Like, it's normal.
I wrote yes.
I'm gonna put yes.
I'm not even gonna pay attention to that one. I can criticize our government and talk about how much I fear its policies and behavior without being seen as a culture.
Dude, terrorism!
How racist do they think our country is?
It's terrorism!
Down with the Muslims.
If you talk about the government and you fear its policies, you are a terrorist.
Yeah, obviously.
Unless you're white.
Unless you're white. Yeah! What did he say? Alright, I'm just gonna say you. Frick.
I mean, we're doing that right now.
Read this next one, I just skimmed through it.
I'm reading this next one?
Yeah, I do the next one.
If a police officer stops me, I can be sure I haven't been singled out because of my race.
Singled out?
Okay.
Okay.
I honestly don't know what to
words.
Say.
I'm out of words.
Okay.
I don't know how to feel about that one. A mixed feeling. First of all, you shouldn't even be getting pulled over in the first place.
This is what I think. Most of the police officers, in my opinion, pull you over if you're doing something wrong.
First of all, most of the time, police officers don't even see the driver when they pull you over.
Yeah.
Second, there's a little more reasoning.
I actually did this study for an essay thing that I wrote, and I did some research on crimes committed in the U.S.
Mm-hmm.
And overall, white males were to do more crime, reported to do more. But I went down and started searching. The murder rates were different.
Oh, yeah.
Blacks, they had a higher murder rate than whites. And there's the white to black ratio in the United States is like, not even close.
Shut up, the truth's racist.
I'm just saying.
Facts don't care about your feelings, you guys.
Ben Shapiro.
Say quick prayer.
Ben, I hope that you sponsor us someday.
Yeah, let us join the Daily Wire.
Okay, I'm putting...
This background's pissing me off.
I know.
I might have to fix that.
I'm putting yes, because I've, like, never gotten pulled over, because I've been following the law.
I'm just gonna say no, because I've never gotten in trouble with a cop. Oh, wait, I'm just gonna say yes.
It's not that hard. Just follow the law. And I think you're good.
And practice abstinence?
Oh, yeah.
Abortion reference!
Number 8.
I can be pretty sure that if I talk to the person in charge... Why is it in quotation marks?
I know.
I'll be facing a person.
Person in charge.
A person in charge. They're not in charge of you, but you just listen to everything they say.
So like a mom.
Exactly. I can... Oh, yeah. It's... I will be facing a person of my race. Also, depends where you work.
Yeah. If I talk to the person in charge, I'll be...
I'm going to say yes.
Right. Honestly, yeah, it doesn't matter. I know, I've been to many, like, job interviews and stuff. Some of them have been white, some black, some Chinese, like... And I haven't gotten hired to any of them. Is that white supremacy? No.
Yes.
So that, I'm putting yes.
They might have mistaked you for black.
They're like, oh, sorry, I had shades on.
Oh, these glasses have been screwing me up the whole time! Okay, oh, they're just like, they're just in the middle of the meeting. Oh, Fred.
Oh, shoot, he's white.
Oh, yeah, you're hired.
sir, you can be the manager.
You're definitely not a lawbreaker. Oh, you're going to like this next one.
I can easily buy books, children's toys, posters, greetings cards, or magazines. What again with the magazines?
All right.
Featuring people of my race.
All right, who buys a greeting card with a black person? Greeting cards don't have people. They have, like, dogs and giraffes or something.
They say, like, have a great day with a freaking dog on it.
Where's the greeting card section with black people on it?
Oh, it's that way, sugar. Mm-hmm. You have to have a black dog, not a white dog.
Yeah.
It's gotta
What be. About what about a white dog with black spots?
Oh, now that's discrimination.
Yeah. Where is freaking zebra?
See, and this is the thing
I'm just
I feel
gonna
like.
Say yes,
this is the thing I feel like with children's toys and stuff. They force it. Just like when they forced the fat, when, you know, the fat Barbie?
Oh.
Did you see that? That's what it reminds me of.
Fat pride, you guys. We're also pro-fat pride.
We're pro-fat pride.
As a child, I had access to books where the heroes and protagonists were the same race and color as me.
Really?
Yeah, just yes. Also, read the next one while I fix the background.
Honestly, I can't even I don't even know because a lot of the books that I read as a child was Dr. Seuss, and I don't know if the Who's or Starbelly Sneetches are my race.
They tried to cancel Dr. Seuss for being racist, though.
Are you serious?
Actually.
Oh yeah. They shut his books off, didn't they?
Yeah.
And they were selling on eBay for like.
Even though the Starbelly Sneetches teaches the best, most pro anti-racist lesson ever.
I don't understand. Like. Could somebody please explain to me why he's racist? I don't understand.
No, the Starbelly Sneetches is actually kind of what taught me as a kid not to be racist.
I think it was that one book where I guess someone said there was like a slave or something.
But no one talks about his porn books he did before he did the kid stuff. No one's talking about that.
As long as there are black people doing the porn.
Oh, yeah. I will definitely look at more black person porn.
Oh, shoot. Okay.
Sponsored by
Okay, on to the next one. I could go home from most meetings of organizations I belong to feeling somewhat tied in, rather than isolated, out of place, outnumbered, unheard, held at a distance, or feared.
Yeah, just yes. Yes,
in my,
I know that.
In my opinion, that's just, it's your personality. It's not what you look like. Like, if you're a talkative, outgoing person, then you're gonna feel like, in place. You're gonna feel tied in.
I never feel in place. That's mainly because I hate people.
I hate everyone.
I'm just goth.
Including Lester.
I'm just goth.
Because not.
Okay. I can take.
So stupid.
All right. Dude, we were at 21.
Not
when we left
lie,
off.
Not gonna lie. Some of the questions I think.
Dude, we need to do some live shows too. We need to do that.
We do.
Alright. 21? Is that where we left off?
Yeah. Let's no, 20. So, next one is 22.
Alright.
I can take a job with an affirmative action employer without having coworkers suspect I got it because of race. Yeah. So my general belief on this one is that if anyone is like hiring because of race and because of who they are, like my dad, they were having my dad try and hire more black people to his team, which I thought was terrible, and even told the employer no, because it's wrong. He said, I'll hire them because of their skill and not their race. The person was okay with that and allowed it to get passed because even they kind of knew deep down it sucked.
Yeah. And I feel like most of the time with, like...
We're going back to square one, though.
Yeah. Most of the time with employers, it's like...
Wait, can I fix that?
Yeah.
See, it's like a little evened off me.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go. Perfect.
All right. Should we just restart?
No, just keep going.
All right. But yeah, so I feel like with employers... Obviously, they don't want to hire someone that's just not going to do their job.
Mm-hmm.
So, even if they're a racist, I feel like that's not going to get in the way.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. Let's see. I can be sure that the gatekeepers in my life, such as my boss, my local MP, or my landlord, are the same color or race as me.
Can we just talk about gatekeepers and how that relates to Ghostbusters?
Yeah, the gatekeeper. Yeah, we got on the Ghostbuster rant.
Are you a god?
Are you a god?
Are you an African American? Then die!
Can we just mention how racist Ghostbusters is?
Yeah, they didn't include Winston enough.
It's annoying.
Just kidding. Winston felt like an extra. He did. Can we just talk about how he felt like an extra?
That is true.
Oh, gosh.
Okay. You go 24?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, I put yes on that one.
Yeah.
Dude, the mic's not been on. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, I almost died.
Dude, I got your reaction. Dude, your face was literally like...
I thought we were back.
It's so sad.
Dude, I would have actually scrapped this whole channel.
No, you could have...
I would just walk out and
no,
leave.
I would have allowed you to punch me because your face, though, the fear, you're like...
I just pick up your camera. Then what the crap is this about?
Let's make a GIF of that.
Yeah.
We'll get that on a T-shirt. In the intro, we can edit.
That'll be our first merch.
Yeah. So for this portion of the week, we are gonna dive into the trailer called "Everything's Gonna Be All White." Stop reacting to me like that.
Everything's gonna be all white.
No, it is the most stupid trailer ever. It's lacking so much consistency, and hardly any thought was put into it.
Basically, it's a documentary. Right?
It's a documentary
about some people.
All right, we are rolling
now. This trailer may trigger
white. What annoys me most about white people is when they pretend like they're the victim.
Immediately realizes herself. She just immediately
What's
turns
also
into
annoying
a victim.
Is when they, you know, when they kill us.
They kill us.
They want to kill us.
Whiteness. When everything has been constructed around.
Thought of a lie. A white person wandering around murdering.
Has been distorted. That doesn't even sound.
It's really just a bunch of white lies.
Oh, that was clever.
Dude, that one hit me hard.
You're not patriots. You're ridiculous.
Says you. You're in the stupid trailer no one cared about.
This is ignorance.
Now that's a dialect.
Did she just really say ignorance? She's like the most ignorant person ever.
Should white people today feel any responsibility for slavery?
Oh,
hell yeah.
Black Jesus.
Wait.
Oh, geography.
Ain't no way Jesus walked around with blonde hair and blue eyes.
He's not blonde. He's like,
no one, there's
like
no proof in the world.
The end of the world already happened like multiple times.
Can we just talk about how Indians killed each other? I mean, Native Americans, it was like the end of the world happened. Well, that you guys kill each other too. It wasn't just us.
BY yogurt or something. Everybody can get behind.
So
the truth has to be
it's
told
funny
about
it's tearing
history.
Down history.
We have to make sure that these stories are told from our perspective.
There's always hope. You know what I'm saying? We don't give up.
It's about obliterating systemic and institutionalized racism.
This is a wild place, y'all. It's a wild place. I know Harriet and Frederick be up there just like, what is they gonna do?
Well, I'm a year closer to death.
Okay.
Any thoughts, guys?
That was something.
That was something different, guys. That one hit me where it hurt. Oh, I can't even. Why would you put so much money into something that everyone knew sucked?
What were even, like, the ratings?
Saturday Night Live, turn it off!
What were they even, like, reviews and ratings on that? Probably, like, 5% on Rotten Tomatoes?
All the comments are straight hate. You look at the comments and everyone's like, what the frick is this?
And I love how every person in that trailer acted like they're the shiz.
Let's put up a yogurt. Let's tear down history and put up a yogurt shop.
They thought they were so funny.
Fred would be up here like, hey, what is going on, fool? Honestly, though, whoever put in so much money and so much time and so much effort into that stupid piece of crap?
I feel bad, honestly, for the producers.
No, they need to be fired from any job.
They need to be shamed.
Showtime sucks anyway, though.
What?
Showtime sucks anyway. Should we watch the trailer for Drag Kids?
Yeah, let's
watch the Drag Kids. And this weekend, Indoctrination of Children.
Next slide, please.
I'll pull this up.
It up. Dude, my search history is going to get flagged by my mom. I was like, what is this, Drag Kids? Yeah.
Oh, wait. Yeah, it's...
No!
Nah, Discovery Plus. Here, wait.
It's a TV show. You ready to see a bunch of young strippers?
What?
Yeah.
This is basically what this crap is.
Your gay strippers.
Oh.
Alright, you ready? A
family vacation. Oh. But it's made by Discovery, so.
Yeah. Well, maybe. Man, this almost made me stop watching Discovery Plus.
We're gonna make a Discovery.
I love Discovery Plus, and this almost made me stop watching. I need to check the microphone again. I'm sorry, you guys. Let's also check at this part.
Willis, my lovely friend.
I first discovered drag at 13. I didn't know what it was, but I knew I wanted it.
Oh, he knew what
it was. But I'm the baby makeup, and I'm someone completely different.
I'm so
pretty! Hello! No, that's gonna be it. That's what nightmares are made of.
I can Independence Day. It's beautiful! And then it just blows you up.
I expected drag to be a part of our lives.
Oh my god, these are so
What are those?
those are stripper boots.
These are so beautiful.
You go, son. You dance on that pole.
My name is Noah, and I'm transgender.
Have you talked to mom and dad about your pictures?
What do you think of taking those photos down? It's a constant reminder that I had to pretend I was a boy.
Do you think my mom would ever want to watch me do drag?
How do I explain
this?
Grow
your dicks when they're older.
No, oh, yeah. Dude, these kids are traumatized as frick.
Making friends has been a hard thing for me to do. When I'm becoming Nemo,
you get a handful.
Become more confident.
Let me make sure you are appropriately fluffed.
Making friends
has been a hard thing
for me
to do.
No wonder you're a stripper.
Become more confident.
Let me make sure you are appropriately fluffed.
Oh, that's what you wanted to tell your 12-year-old before going out.
Anyway, when you dance on the pole, be sure to always have your butt on a good angle.
Oh, never make sure you remember to be properly fluffed.
And always let the men put money in your bra.
We need that as well.
That look I got. That looks into it.
Oh my gosh, so this girl
Dude, who is
wow.
judging this show? Who's going here at their night and watching these kids?
This is me, and you better like it.
You better like it.
Oh, I'm a graphic.
Anyone, any judge in that show was definitely a pedophile.
It made me laugh.
they were going there to see little kids dancing. Yeah.
It's just a side hobby. I mean, I only mostly enjoy the tiny dresses.
All the properly fluffed children.
Yeah, let me properly fluff you. That sounds so horrible.
That sounds awful. But then again, it is the drag queen, so.
Well, guys, Thank you for coming along. You just gave us a horrible idea to watch this awful show. Adios!
Ow.
Should I recreate the Independence Day speech?
No, it's not gonna happen.
You can do Bird on Field even for YouTube.
It's not gonna hit the same.
We played it, and I was not.
Tyson did it, and
yeah.
I was.
Show Brandon, I agree. Clouds rain, train whistles blow, and guitars play. Preachers preach, farmers plow, wishes go up, and the world goes round. And I.